identity. One word that communicates the uniqueness of each individual, object, or place. Tarlac is known for its sumptuous foods, breathtaking sceneries, and is one of the passageways for travelers heading to North and Manila. But there is one thing Tarlac is mainly recognized for. It is dubbed as the melting pot of the Philippines, primarily because of the diversity in terms of its people.
But if the Tarlacanos themselves were to be asked what they think is the identity of someone who resides in the province of Tarlac really is, what would be their answers?
I think Tarlacanos, welcoming din. And hindi naman tayo magiging diverse and melting pot if we're not that welcoming sa ibang ethnicity.
Ang isang Tarlacanos ay diverse. Kasi may Ilocano, merong Kapampangan sa Tarlac. So, kaya ang isang Tarlacanos ay diverse. By means of culture, maraming mimix na culture sa province natin.
No wonder why Tarlac is known as the melting pot of the Philippines from the responses of our fellow Tarlacanos alone. But I know someone who is more knowledgeable about the roots of Tarlacanos. Well, why don't we ask him?
Why is Tarlac named as the melting pot of the Philippines?
Yung Tarlac is so-called the melting pot. Parang you will imagine isang lutuin gaya ng sinigang, which is a combination of many ingredients, may gulay, may karne. So Tarlac was actually among the last provinces to be created in Central Luzon. And Tarlac was not a cultural province or was not an ethno-linguistic province like Pampanga or Ilocos or Pangasinan. It is actually an economic province. It is not a cultural province. It was created as an economic province combining towns from Pangasinan and Pampanga. And then it is a bordering province with the Tagalogs of Nebisia. And it is the point of migration of many groups like the Ilocanos and the Kapampangans. And lastly, it was the last sanctuary of the Aitas. No?
Who are the first Tarlacanos?
So, as I've said, Tarlac was said to be, or we can see it is the last sanctuary of the indigenous people. Especially the Aitas, no?
Doctor, how would you describe a Tarlacanyo?
So, we could describe a Tarlacanyo as more or less part of an entity that is not purely ethno-linguistic. A Tarlacanyo is a mixture of these different ethno-linguistic groups, no? And identity. So what when we talk of a Tarlacanyo, we talk of a multicultural entity. No?
For our last question, Doctor, what do you think is so unique about the people of Tarlac?
So Tarlac is very unique. If you will analyze the history of Tarlac, it was created only as a passageway between the north and the south, no? Parang dinadaanan lang ang Tarlac talaga. So, walang nag-i-stay, no? Parang Tarlac was created to provide a bridge between the south and the north.
Thank you, Doctor. Well, why don't we visit one of our Aita Maganchi friend in Bamban and know her story?
We are now here at Sitio Baras in the municipality of Bamban, and it is one of the places here in Tarlac where our fellow Aita Maganchi tribe resides. Come and let's have a conversation with one of my friends. Hello! Ano po sa tingin niyo yung unique about ay dun sa ano niyo po, kultura niyo po?
Yung unique
po dito sa amin, karamihan lang po kasi ginagawa po talaga dito yung mga nagtatanim, tapos may mga dumadayo po na minsan nagbibigay po sila ng tulong. Parang ganun lang po.
Sa tingin niyo po, ano yung pinagkaiba niyo sa ibang mga Tarlacan, sa mga Kapampangan po, sa mga Ilocano, sa mga iba po dito na nakatira sa Tarlac?
Sa amin po, yung pinagkaiba lang po namin kasi po yung mga banda po sa baba po, ang ano lang po talaga nila, yan yung magtrabaho. Pero dito po talaga sa amin po, yung parang pinagkaiba po namin, minsan po magtatanim lang po kami kung wala po talagang makain. Harvest lang po namin, yun na po yung pangkain po namin.
Sa sariling pananaw niyo naman, ano po sa tingin niyo yung kaya niyong maibigay dun sa mga kapwa niyo dito?
Bilang isang estudyante rin po, kaya nag-agriculture po talaga yung kurso ko. Pinaka-target ko po, mas lalong matuto sa pagtatanim. Kasi po yung mga kulot po, ginagawa po nila. Yung parang, imbis na ibenta po nila yung lupa po nila, gawin na lang po nila ang pantanim para mas lalo po yung kikitain po nila po doon.
Tarlac being the melting pot of the Philippines resonates that the province indeed does not have a single identity, but a conglomerate of individuals with unique face, language, and culture. Again, this has been Bren Noah M. Nieto, and this is Persons of Tarlac.